we've seen traditional manufacturing. So what we're going to look at now is some of the more modern manufacturing methods. This is our additive manufacturing area. This is Sam and this is Huey, and they're going to tell you a little bit about additive manufacturing and our equipment, and I'll turn it over to them.
Welcome. I'm Samantha Barber.
I'm Huey.
I'm
in D&D with Tim and John in the meeting.
I'm in paint engineering, so I'm a little off from what you've seen around here.
Here for the tilt lab, we've got three types of 3D printers. We've got the Conex 500, and it's a liquid base. What it does is sprays it on there, and it rolls over, and then it cures it with a UV light to harden it. And these are some examples of what it's printed. We've got the S370s behind me. Those actually work off of a spool of material instead of the liquid. And then we've got the Mark Forge down here. That it's also a spool, but it's got embedded carbon fiber, so we can get some of those aluminum properties with weight and some of those lighter things. So we can try that with that carbon fiber embedded in there. So the Conex 500 is our most accurate, so it's slower to print. You can have up to maybe 24-hour print jobs on it. It can be pretty long. You can do very large parts, even up to maybe the size of an engine or components of an engine we put together. And we can do that to help our shops install equipment and do those kind of checks ahead of whenever we could get a prototype part made from metal or the other materials. So we can do all kinds. You're welcome to touch any of this, check it out, pick it up. There's rubber, there's the soft parts, there's the hard plastics. So these handles, our TTC, our group up in Michigan, is actually doing an e-brake ergonomic study based on handle length. So it's something like that, that rather than having a vendor make it, we can print off a couple, ship them up there, and they can do those kind of studies right in the midst of designing the vehicle. These next three, that wrench and then these two bearings, this is all printed all at once, actually. So all one print, and then we use the water to blast it all out, and we clean it up, and then we don't have any assembly to do, and we've got these functional parts. So we'll do things like this. Yep. And this one, it can do many types of materials and colors. This one's a little limited, but even like rubber, so if we need hoses or wire harness or things that need to be flexible, this is here for that. The types of plastic we use, based on what your job is, if you're outside, you want to make sure it's UV stable. If it's inside, maybe you can use a different material for application. For these lighter ones, you can check these bigger parts, but they're really lightweight. They're less than what you'd expect, but with those triangular, it's a complex structure. It can be very strong and very light at the same time. And there's all kinds of things we can do. People that are coming down to learn, you can make accessory holders, right? You got your watch, your phone, your AirPods, you can pull this kind of stuff off the internet. And that's the kind of stuff we learn with. We want to encourage them to come down here and learn. What's it like to use 3D printers? Because that gets them geared up for their job, and they'll think about that more as they're doing their work each day. Mark that you met in VR earlier, he goes to a lot of the additive conferences. And this one was new this year. This is sand casting. So our engine, our unit plants use this because the, you know, the molten metals would dissolve any of this very quickly. So we use sand casting. Now they're 3D printing sand casting. So this is something that we can do those kind of same quick trials over with them in this space where we have to do that. So we're evaluating this, see if it's something that'd be beneficial to Toyota to move forward and reduce some of those lead times.
So,
he's done a lot of projects with this.
Yeah, so a lot of projects we've done is more just expediting the design, right? You can go from design to actual physical part in a very relative short lead time. Whereas before, you can imagine just to do a complex shape like this to do trial for handling and just conforming, we'd have to design it, bring it to a fabricator, create the mold, create the machining, get approval, budgeting, or if you come down, print maybe a $75 part for materials versus maybe $7,000 parts for parts, just commodities, just to source and create it. So we've done a lot of high volume trials with the parts, spray samples. So we printed a full bumper corner because styling has some ideas for very radical shapes, but paint, we can't paint everything. We have some restriction on our materials and our technology. So now we bring it here, we can test the shape at a much quicker rate. Rather than waiting for a typical 12-week lead time, we could do it maybe less than a week time, like that. So the idea is added manufacturing just to build parts on quickly and test faster. It's all about cutting lead time, costs, and how to get that feedback loop faster. So we have our design team make the product and design it faster rather than waiting for us to trial as a bottleneck. That's some of the applications we've done so far.
So I understand with 3D printed parts, they're in their infancy in automotive, and the standards are still being written. Is that right? The like durability, quality standards. It's kind of like the wild west right now, and everybody's sort of putting up their own.
I'll say so. Right now, we're probably using it for more prototype parts to use into a manufacturing environment to mass produce and what spec it would be to actually meet Toyota requirements for testing. Yeah, we're not at that stage yet. That's
so
probably just the future.
You don't have any 3D printed parts of Toyota's yet?
No, not yet. I would say that's part of a future standpoint. Yeah, the first part here is just to test it out and then combine this creativity from concept to reality.
Yeah, none of our production vehicles do, but we do have, if you see some of the motorsports cars, the aero package on the front, that front splinter, was all 3D printed here with the engineers. And so we're using it for things like that. It went on one lap of America, raced the whole week, even, you know, whenever they get off the track and they didn't have, it was durable enough to handle all of that and finish the week. So that is something we do here, but it's not out on our production.
And it's really good at high variety, low volume, and 300,000 cameras a year is just quite hard. We're not quite there for that level of speed on additive manufacturing yet. So, but certainly for some of the low volume stuff or low option count stuff, it's being investigated, but currently not in production. But like Sam said, when we get a break, we can take a look at the camera that's out there and see the package of stuff that we printed here that ran in one way.